All right then, so I want to show you one more thing before we move on and start to create that farm validation in the second half of this series, and that is how to match alternate characters or words. And we do that using the pipe symbol like so. So it's a straight line going down, and you might have seen a double pipe symbol in JavaScript meaning or. Well, a single pipe in regular expressions means or as well. So say for example, we wanted to match either P or, we do a pipe, T. This here will match either P or T. So if I do a P, it's going to match. If I do a T, it's going to match. If I do any other character, it's not going to match. Okay? So what if I wanted to match either pyre or tyre? Well, what would you think? We can't just do YRE here because this is saying, well, match either P or tyre. It's not saying match P or T, then ire. If I do pyre, this will not work. It just matches this P at the start. However, if I do tyre, then it does work. And a T on its own doesn't work because like I said, we're not matching P or T, we're matching P or tyre, okay? So what if I wanted to do something like this? Or if I wanted to, for example, match either pyre or tyre? Well, this is gonna match either of those two words. So if I change this to pyre, then that's gonna match as well. But a simpler way to do this, since YRE stays the same on both sides, is to enclose the or in a set of parentheses. So if we do P, then pipe, then T, we're saying, okay, well, this should match either P or T, then after this, YRE. So pyre now matches, but also tyre will match. Okay, so what these parentheses do right here is say to the regular expression, look, I want you to evaluate this part right here as a separate entity, if you like. Treat it as its own mini regular expression. Then the next stuff, carry on evaluating, okay? So that's how we can do something like this. And again, if we wanted to, you know, match maybe three things, we can do something like that. So we could say in here, pet, I don't know, toy, and then do another pipe symbol, crazy, then get rid of YRE. I'll do a space, first of all, then rabbit. So now this is going to match either pet space rabbit, toy space rabbit, or crazy space rabbit. Okay, so let's try that. Pet rabbit, this gets a match. Toy rabbit, and let's put the global flag on here so we can match each one. This gets a match. And finally, crazy rabbit, if we spell it correctly, also gets a match. But if we do anything else, like, I don't know, hello rabbit, this is not going to match. Let's just bring something in from our previous tutorials. Let's try adding on a question mark after this set of parentheses right here. So what we're saying now is everything inside these parentheses, when you evaluate that separately, whatever's in there is going to be optional. It can appear either 0 or 1 times. So if we take away all this stuff here, then space rabbit will also get a match because all of this stuff here is now optional. The space isn't optional, but this stuff within it is optional, okay? So that's how we use these pipe symbols to say, look, I want to match one thing or another, and that's how we also use parentheses to evaluate certain parts of our regular expressions separately before we move on.